Dr. Amanda with Straightsmile Solutions, straightsmilesolutions.com, and I just wanted to pose this subject. What is a healthy Invisalign or clear aligner refinement rate? Do you even know what your refinement rate is? You should know what your refinement rate is. It's not that hard to find out. You can just audit, say, a year's worth of cases that were completed and then backtrack to see how many had refinements and how many nailed it on the first go and what your percentage is. Or if you're only doing Invisalign, my understanding is that there is an analytics button that you can opt into that will give you the exact refinement rate on your completed cases. I know where it is. However, I haven't figured out how to opt into it. No one from Invisalign has ever returned my inquiries on this, and my TM doesn't know either. But you should know. And what do I think is healthy? Well, I think a refinement rate should be less than 30%. If yours is more than 30%, you're doing something wrong, basically. So we can go more over this on how to avoid it, what the issue is. I mean, obviously, if you're using a main company like Invisalign or ClearCorrect, maybe Reveal. I'm not going to put SureSmile in that bucket because I've seen all kind of manufacturing issues with their stuff. So I'm pretty much going to put, just say, Invisalign and ClearCorrect. Even Global, I'm using Global white label aligners in our practice, and they're great at $20 a pot. I have no problems with their manufacturing. So you got that, the manufacturing. That shouldn't be an issue if you're using a main one. So take that off the table as what's going on if you're having refinements. And refinements could also be mid-course corrections, warranty fit, all that stuff kind of goes into all the same bucket, you know? Occasionally there's one-offs, but it should be a very random thing. Second thing is your treatment plan. Most commonly, it's one of two things. It's either the treatment plan or it's a lack of accountability loop compliance program. You gotta have all these things. If you don't have all these things line up, it's not gonna work out. You're gonna have a high refinement rate. There are plenty of orthodontists that have less than 10% refinement rates. I mean, that's how good they are at A, doing really good treatment plans, accurate, predictable treatment plans, B, picking the right patients, of course, and C, creating an accountability loop. Let's talk about that. What is an accountability loop? An accountability loop is exactly what it sounds like. I mean, hey, I've got kids at home and we do accountability loops all the time, you know? Did you do your homework? Yes, no. I mean, you gotta show it to me, you know? How do you demonstrate that things were actually done? Accountability loop. I don't care if it's a sticker chart, if it's I check, we do inspection, whatever. Same thing with aligner patients. I don't care if they're 10, 7, 70, 50, everybody needs an accountability loop. That just means, how do I know that they're actually doing what they're saying they're doing? And that always cracks me up when you guys are like, my patient says they're wearing them. I call BS on that because I look at the pictures and I'm like, well, do you have pictures every single aligner of them checking in? I don't care if you're using dental monitoring, dental monitoring system, what was now called Align Flow, which is now called In-Hand Orthodontics. That's their new company name. I don't care if you create your own in-house program. There's all kinds of other they're always spouting up new companies that are out there that basically use apps or phones or scan boxes or whatever it is to snap pictures at before every aligner change to send it to the doctor or the team or send it to AI. I don't really care who's doing it to say if you can change the aligner or not. It's that simple. It can be done manually. It can be done with AI if you don't want to deal with it, if you want to pay for someone to do it. Really, really, really easy. Go, no go. Change, no change. Yes, you're ready to change. No, you're not. That's all you do. Is you create an accountability loop. It's actually quite easy to do, to create an in-house one, or you can purchase one of these programs. I know that the In-Hand Orthodontics, the one I said used to be called Align Flow, I looked on their website and I think it's $140 a month for 30 patients. I mean, that's not bad if you do the math on that. That's just a few dollars per patient per month to not have refinements. Why not? So anyways, just wanted to pose this topic to you. Discuss. If you have questions, we're glad to help you out. Thank you.